In the next few minutes, you're gonna discover why this weird-looking, typhoon-looking framework is literally the answer to take your sales to a whole new level. Now, what is this over here? Well, if you take a look at this, this is two different models. The representation of one business model on the left-hand side here, which is shrinking, and on the right-hand side is a business that is constantly building and growing on its own. Now, the question is, how do we make it so that we can transition from a churn and burn model and transition from here to here? Now, by the end of this video, I'm going to be walking you through five different techniques on why most marketers, when they focus on getting more leads, more sales, it's usually under this model and not this model, and what it is that you could be doing in order to transition. In fact, this technique over here is the main technique that we utilize to scale from 7 to 8 figures, but it really doesn't matter. As long as you want to scale, whether it's 5 to 6, 6 to 7, you're going to realize that making that transition is absolutely crucial. So, first of all, to kind of explain this, I'm going to utilize this terminology that if you take a look at what's happening in the world here today, you're going to notice that when people are, I'm not going to use the C word, but the C word is basically what's happening in the world right now in case YouTube flags this video for some reason. But in order to track like the cases that's happening on a daily basis, they utilize this terminology called the R-naught. And what the R-naught is, it is a terminology to kind of monitor how viral this thing is spreading. Now, what if this over here is literally what dictates whether the business grows on its own? So the R-naught, this number over here, is to dictate to see if it's going to expand on its own, or is it shrinking, or is it dying, right? Or is it going viral on its own? And if the number is more than one, what it really means is that if one person gets it, it's going to spread to more than one person, right? However, if it's less than one, it means that it's eventually shrinking. Now, what does this have to do with a thriving business model? Well, everything. Why? Because if you take a look at most business models, in terms of acquiring customer and a strategy, looks like this, where they get a customer and eventually it dies out on its own, where they're utilizing paid ads, social media, and it's a churn and burn model where they get this new lead, this new sale. And after that, most business owners, what do they try to do? They try to get more new customers. Now, while there's nothing wrong with paid ads, I'd like you to notice the most common focus of what most marketers do when it comes to traffic. Most traffic, when it comes to paid, right? There are these few types of traffic, right? That most marketers usually focus and put their energy and effort on, which is either paid or it could be earned media. So this would be like doing a YouTube video, you know, posting on Instagram, organic, right? Where you have to earn, but it really still doesn't belong to you. Or this could be traffic that you own, right? That's truly yours. So this could be like your list, your mobile numbers, the people who have opted in and given you permission to market to them. So if you take a look at what most marketers do and talk about, most marketers focus on these three types of traffic, which is, how do I run ads on Facebook, YouTube, Google? How do I earn and build that following, whether it's through podcasting, YouTube videos just like this one, and how can I convert that traffic to traffic that I own? Now, the problem is, if you send traffic to a business model that looks like this, where R, right, is less than one, what it ultimately means is that eventually this lead, this sale that you make will die out on its own, eventually. And if you want to be able to have a business model that grows on its own so that you maximize every paid lead, every paid customer that comes in, we got to think about, well, how do we change this so that our R value, right, is more than one? How do we make that happen? Which is this. Which means, if you can turn this business model around by making it so that every time you feed your system, whether it's through paid, earned, or owned media, it is now growing on its own. So this is where I want to be able to walk you through the five different techniques, okay? So number one, if you want to be able to kind of transition from this model to this model, the first thing to really think about is how can you make it so that there is some sort of referral as part of the buying experience, okay? Now, what do I mean by referral? So this is like one of the quickest win in order to compound every buyer or lead that you get. So think about this way. If you're selling a product, I remember recently, just about 2 weeks ago, I received this really nice gift from a shop where a friend sent me a basket of fruits. I mean, it was a really nice basket. And the sad thing was this, like I took a picture of this and I wanted to tag my friend and the store that my friend got it from. But the sad thing is, like on the picture, there was no mention of what the store name is or what the Instagram handle is. And that thing was sad because, like I felt sad because this person missed out on potential free organic traffic. So the first thing I'd like you to think about is how can you take the buying experience of your product so that when somebody unboxes it, when somebody receives this welcome kit, when somebody goes to this physical location of yours, when somebody joins your live event, your course, your training, can you create moments where they will want to take a picture of it and post on social media on your behalf because they're proud of it? Because if you can do that, that is when you're going to change that business model where it's churn and burn and have it grow on its own, because now for every buyer or every lead that you get, they're now helping you build upon that organic. So now it grows on its own, right? So the way I'd like you to think about is if you have a physical location, and I know that, you know, brick and mortar and retail is getting hit really hard right now still, but think of it as, can I make this moment Instagrammable where they will want to tag me or utilize a hashtag? And that's huge as well. So like, for example, if I am doing events, one of the things that I might have is in the pre-training, I would say, well, share with me what are some of the things that you want to be able to get out of this event, right? Why? Because I want to be able to build that referral traffic and organic as well. Same thing with if somebody signs up and is part of our community at our high level, we'll literally physically send them a welcome gift. In fact, when I did live events before the world went on lockdown, that's what people will get. Why? Because again, it's not because of the physical thing, but because it's an Instagrammable moment where people could be taking a picture of it, tagging us, and now we get free organic traffic as part of this. Okay, and this is one of the quickest, lowest hanging fruit that you can apply and implement that doesn't cost you anything, that is going to enable you to transition your business model to now no longer have just a shrinking business model where you have to constantly feed the system with more paid ads and more owned, earned media, but rather utilize this. So that's number one. That brings us to number two. Number two is WOM, word of mouth, okay? How can you get people talking about it? So what you can do as part of your process, as part of your onboarding, as part of when somebody receives that physical product, when somebody logs into your digital members area, how can you get people talking about it as part of your process? So think about whether you're doing a virtual event, whether it's a members area, whether it's a physical product, can you get them to utilize a specific hashtag so that now there's this feedback loop and there's a reason for them to be talking about it? So for example, like when we do our virtual events and even live events, one of the things that I would say is I could take a group picture with the attendees and I would post it in the group and I would say, let me know what your biggest takeaways are and what it is, how you feel from this day one experience. Okay, so because of that, again, it's incentivizing your audience to talk about it. So if you're selling some sort of experience, if you're selling a physical product, right? How can you include that as part of the experience so that there's this feedback loop where they could go to and comment or take a picture or post on their feed so that now there is this word of mouth happening organically as a part of this. So to kind of spin off number two, and this kind of double down number two to do it better, this could be number three, heavily related to number two, which is your onboarding process. What this means is to get people talking, how can you integrate this onboarding process so that the moment they buy this thing, physical, digital, training, course, virtual event, when they buy it, when they give you their name and email, when they register for their product or event or training, there is a series and a sequence of emails that follows up with them that continues to build and nurture this relationship that builds credibility, trust, that continues to add value so that it either ascends them to the next thing or to a higher ticket or to an upsell or, which is number four over here, and I know I'm kind of speeding things up over here, does it make sense for them to become an affiliate? Right now, this of course depends on your business model, but sometimes it could be the case that your buyers would be the best people that would be incentivized to promote your product, right? And does it make sense for you to either turn some of your customers to affiliates or strategic partners in your market or in a related market to become a business partner to work with you? Now, there's the right way and the wrong way to this, okay? So when I say affiliate, sometimes people think about how they drop their name card to somebody else and to them, like that's kind of like it, right? Dropping them an email saying, hey bro, I've got this amazing product, go promote my product, and we're giving 50% commissions. That's not what I'm talking about. What makes a great offer to get somebody, not just to be an affiliate, but to be actively promoting it, is two things, okay? If you want to be able to transition to this. Number one is, can you add value to the affiliate so that their customers also benefit from them being your affiliate? So for example, if let's say I am selling a software that shows people how to track their leads and to get better ROI, right? So if I were to go to an affiliate or a potential affiliate, I don't want to just come from the angle of,
hey bro, we've got an amazing software that pays out 50% every single month,
right? Because that's what everybody does. What we want to be able to do is, can we integrate that offer as part of what the affiliate does in their business model so that their customer would benefit from the affiliate promoting your product? So imagine if you said, okay, I can see that right now you are in the business of real estate and we have this software to generate leads and track them and to be able to scale and follow up these leads, right? So imagine if I went to the affiliate and said, look, whenever you close a sale or whenever you get a lead, what's going to happen is you are going to introduce this thing here as part of what it is that you do. And because of that, your customers get a better experience. Number two, they are onboarded to this affiliate software a whole lot better. And as a result of that, not only does it add value to your customers, that is when obviously the affiliate makes money as well. And that is the key to making this thing happen. If I were to promote somebody else's product as an affiliate, right, and vice versa, I'm always thinking not like, can I send an email out? That's not what affiliate marketing is to me. If I am serious about either having somebody promote me or promoting somebody else, I'm thinking about how can I integrate it as part of what I do, and does it make sense to do that long term so that it's a win for both parties, a win to my customers and a win to the business model as well, so that now it's growing, okay, through word of mouth, through affiliate. And that brings us to number five. So number five, it's about smashing the like button for the YouTube algorithm. Guys, if you're enjoying this so far, this helped the channel out. Subscribe to the channel if you want to be able to see more videos just like this one. And that brings us to the last piece. And number five is thinking about how I can systematically get reviews or case studies or testimonials. So the way to get good at this step over here, if you want to be able to fuel and make this thing happen, is to think about, well, how can I make sure that my customers are successful in what it is that, and they're getting what it is that they paid for, and they're getting value a lot more than what it is that they paid for. Because if you can do that, that is when you're gonna get reviews, whether it's through your Facebook page, whether it's through a third-party software, whether it is through video submissions, right, or whether it's on Yelp. But again, coming from this angle is, think about, can you make it so that as part of your follow-up process after somebody buys, you are now able to utilize them wanting and willingly to submit these reviews, whether it's through Google reviews or Facebook or through a comment or through a video submission or through Yelp. Why? Because when they do that, again, that's when you're really able to maximize every single person that comes through this channel over here, right? So this piece here is, and one of the things that we do is, we have an email sequence that goes out that ties in with the purchase. So not only do we show them how do we get them to be successful using the products that they bought, but as part of that process is, 1 week later, we would literally have an email that goes out that says, hey, tell us about your experience. And we've got submissions for different products on different platforms. Sometimes it's just going to Facebook and leaving a review. Sometimes it's on, you know, sending us a video. Sometimes it's on Google. So this is where, again, you're now facilitating this. And the question is this, you know, most of the time when people say, you know, can you give me a testimonial? They're not fully utilizing it. And not only are they not fully utilizing it, they are not integrating this piece here as part of their business model in order to bring the R value to more than one, so that for every one customer that comes in, they get more than one customer out in return. And when you start thinking like this, when it comes to this specific framework, that is how you really start to maximize every single lead and every single sale that comes in. Hope this technique helps. This is a technique that we utilize, that I'm always thinking about, so that I'm not just relying on paid traffic. I love paid traffic, but rather also maximize every single click and every single buyer that comes through our process. Hope this video helps. Let me know in the comments below what is some of your biggest takeaway is. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.